Catherine, and I'm presenting today my project stage 3, where I'm talking about my market trip and vendor selection. If you forgot, my store's Rise and Grind. It was about athleisure and just kind of having something for both men and women in a variety of sizes. So I'm going to be talking about what market I chose to attend and the vendors that I chose to supply my store. So just to recap project stage 2, we talked about like the product trends that we were going to be seeing. And so I picked one of the majors from each category that we were assigned. So for style and silhouette, I wanted to bring up the 80s product trend that we're going to be seeing in 2018. These silhouettes are like bigger and broader, and they're in a lot of different colors and fabrics. And so this means a big impact on athleisure because people are buying things that are bigger and usually comfy clothes. You want them to be bigger. And then a fabric and texture that I thought was interesting and kind of strange at the same time was the clear plastic. And clear plastic outerwear is having a major revival. This type of material is out of the ordinary, but the top names in fashion are using it, and so it's going to be trickling down. And I thought that like with athleisure as like a jacket or something like that, like it could be really unique for an athleisure brand. And then with color is like, the colors for fall and winter are very non-traditional coming up in 2018. So like there's like super bright colors, which is weird for the fall and winter because usually those colors are more neutral, and there are still neutrals, and I did pick a lot of neutrals, but there's definitely gonna be some brights. And then a fanny pack was a detail or an accessory that has been seen on stars within the past year, but now it's like becoming, like a lot of designers are using it too. It's not just like your Kendall Jenner or Bella Hadid and like those kind of people that are using it. So moving into the market that I picked to attend, I chose America's Mart in Atlanta, Georgia, because it operates year round. They have a lot to choose from as far as like athleisure vendors go. They have apparel shows, like for right now in 2018, they have April, June, August, and October. So they always have like different shows that supply for different seasons. And then there's also apparel shows that are also just for like gift and like homeware. And then there's special ones like for prom or bridal and things like that. And I chose this because my store, Rise and Grind, is going to be in Charleston, South Carolina. And Atlanta is within driving distance from Charleston, and it provides the vendors that I need. So looking at the market trip budget, I went through like gas costs, hotel costs, parking costs, and all that kind of stuff, and kind of just summed it all up. So gas was not that expensive. I took the average prices in Georgia and South Carolina, added them together, divided them by 2, and that's how I got based on my car gas mileage. The hotel and food that I found, I got both of these things from the America's Mart website, because they have a really interactive website that you can click on to be like, I'm gonna get, like, these are suggestions for food and these are suggestions for hotels. So the hotel is within walking distance to America's Mart, like it's right there at it. You do have to pay to park, and as far as like breakfast, lunch, and dinner, it's about $15 to $30 a person, depending on where you are eating. But there's also things at the apparel show that you can like get for free as like with your registration. So that's also an option. And so the total is about $950 in travel expenses for this market trip from Charleston to Atlanta, Georgia, which if you're only doing it twice a year, which is what I'm planning to do, is doing it twice a year, then in the grand scheme of things, it's really not that much to do the market. Okay, so this is just like a sample schedule about like kind of what 3 to 4 days would look like at market for me. I took all of these like examples, like the networking buyer brunch and like the fashion show and the influencer style panel. Those are all events that America's Mart is actually having for their April market. But those are all kinds of things that they would have at any market. And so I'm planning to attend market twice a year for Rise and Grind. So in February and in June. Their February market is the 5th through the 9th, and then their June market is the 13th through the 16th. And so these shows would kind of encapsulate like summer and fall and spring, and I'm not planning to like really like delve into buying for winter just because the weather in Charleston is so different. You don't need like huge winter things or like a huge winter influence. But this is just like a sample of like the kinds of things that would be going on. Like one day I would be looking for like all women's stuff and like doing like a networking buyer brunch, and like being able to like just come into contact with like all the other buyers or like the influencers there. On a Wednesday I would be looking for all of my men's stuff, so my men's tops, my men's bottoms, and then weaving in on Thursday like accessories and like looking at the temporary showrooms as opposed to the permanent showrooms, just to see like what's new and just kind of like networking the whole time while I'm there. Okay, so moving into what vendors I selected for what product classification. So I have women's tops, women's bottoms, men's tops, men's bottoms, and accessories. And so for my women's tops, the vendor that I chose was Linder, and they are actually a foreign market. They are based in the UK, and there was no contact information for them. There was just a like contact information through inquiry because it is a foreign market. But I really liked their like clean cut, like just tops, like they were simple enough, but they were also like the back of this is super like intricate in the back, and then just like a plain like white like brand name top. And so that's really like, I want like Rise and Grind to be simple, but I also want it to be like interesting and fun. And so with women's bottoms, the brand that I chose, or the vendor that I chose for women's bottoms, was Langston, and it's based in Los Angeles, California. And everything, I probably would pick everything that they had, and these are just a few examples, but like just like the white legging and the black legging, and then just like the like 80s material and like color short, things like that. I really liked everything they had. They had a bunch of different bright colors too, which also fit into all of the like product trends that were happening. Moving into men, it was harder to find athleisure clothes for men than I thought it was going to be, but it was kind of difficult, but I ended up finding a vendor called Saks to do like the men's tops because they don't need anything like fancy or like interesting or anything. But I like this color that they had because it was like that bright, like unusual color that was supposed to be seen in like the fall and the winter. And then for men's bottoms, the vendor that I chose was Alternative Apparel. They didn't really have like legging type material, which I liked because as far as athleisure for men, I usually think like a jogger pant, like something that's like super comfortable. And so they had like this style pant in all kinds of colors. They're based out of Georgia, so they're actually super close to where America's Mart is. And so they have these in all kinds of different colors, and I thought that it worked really well with the store concept for Rise and Grind. And then last, I have my vendor for my accessories, and it was Carbon 38. I kind of came across it on a whim, but it ended up being perfect. Like, they had every single accessory that I could ever wanted, like from water bottles and the fanny pack and just socks and just like basic accessories that necessarily, yes, they could, like another customer that wasn't at Rise and Grind could get these, but I wanted them to be like fun and interesting, and these were all just like super trendy colors and things like that for accessories. So in conclusion, these are all my work cited, but just kind of in summary, I tried to find vendors that really encompassed all the product trends that I was seeing when I was doing Project Stage 2, and I ended up at America's Mart because it was just the most convenient, and going twice a year and only spending $950 to get there about was just seemed like the best option.